At the age of 26, self-educated Robert Hooke was commissioned by King Charles II of England to study insects and report his findings at the Royal Society of London meetings. Hooke first needed a tool to help him complete his task. He needed a microscope. However, the microscopes of the time were not quite up to the task, so he built the first illuminated compound microscope. Hooke was not only able to study insects, as tasked by the king, but he was able to use his microscope to study plants, sponges, bird feathers, and other objects, which had, to this point, never been seen at this level. The results of his studies are published in his book, Micrographia, which included detailed records of his observations. Some peers thought Hooke was a genius. Others could not see the value in his work. Hooke, however, was able to secure his place in history while attending a Royal Society of London meeting when he placed a piece of cork under his microscope. And to his amazement, he wrote, "I could exceedingly plainly perceive it to be all perforated and porous, much like a honeycomb, but that the pores of it were not regular. These pores were indeed the first microscopic pores I ever saw, and perhaps that were ever seen." What had Hooke discovered? Cells. Every living thing is made up of cells. Some organisms have one cell. We have somewhere in the ballpark of 37 trillion cells. Do you know how many cells that is? It is more than the number of stars in the universe. It's 37 trillion, okay? So let's think about this number a little differently. If we were able to line up our cells end to end to end, we would have enough cells to circle the Earth more than 2 times. Whether an organism is single-celled or multi-celled like we are, all organisms have one thing in common, a little thing called life. There are over 200 different shapes and sizes of cells in your body, doing many different jobs. But despite these differences, cells have the same basic structures inside. Cells are sacs filled with jelly-like substance that is surrounded by a membrane. The jelly contains chemicals and structures that are called organelles. There are many different organelles, each carrying out specific functions responsible for maintaining homeostasis and therefore sustaining life. Some organelles, for example, play a role in the synthesis and breakdown of macromolecules, such as proteins, carbohydrates, and lipids, and are important in metabolism and energy storage. While other organelles play a role in replication, support, and movement. Cells are to the body what brick and mortar, lumber, electrical wire, etc., are to a house, building blocks. Cells are the building blocks which form organ systems, and their ability to carry out their functions is dependent on cells that form them. In this module, we will study the cell and macromolecules. More specifically, we will study the structure, function, and coordinated actions of cellular organelles. To fully understand this material, however, we must review the macromolecules and relate that knowledge to our understanding of cells.